Okay, we're moving on to dividing rational expressions. So remember, that's like dividing fractions. So keep in mind, how do you divide fractions? What if you had A over B divided by C? Well, that would mean A over B times the reciprocal 1 over C, and you would get A over BC. So that's if you just have a single term after the division bar here. If you have a fraction divided by a fraction, it's A over B times the reciprocal D over C. AD over BC. So to divide rational expressions, we're just going to first change division to multiplying by the reciprocal. Then we're going to go ahead and use the same technique we did for multiplying rational expressions, which was the same technique as simplifying. You just factor everything. Hopefully, a lot of stuff cancels out, and you're done. Okay, let's start with this one. 12x cubed y over 7 divided by 9x squared over 14y cubed. Step 1 is to multiply by the reciprocal. And now you see if you can cancel anything. And if you want, you could even write it out the long way, every single factor. Or you could use your laws of exponents, etc. Right? So if you wrote it all out the long way, for 12, I'm going to do the numbers first. 12 is 2 times 2 times 3, right? And then we'd have x times x times x times y. And then, I think I'm going to run out of room here. I'm going to make this a little bit smaller. Let's see. And keep on going here. All right, so then we've got the 14, 2, 7, and then we have 3 more y's, right? Okay, barely get them in there. All right, and in the bottom we have a 7, we have a 3, an x. So if you want, you could actually write every single thing out like this, and you can cancel the 3, you can cancel the 7s, you can cancel 2 of these x's with 2 of those x's, and that looks like it's it. And what you have left is those 2's, here's another 2, an x, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 y's. So what I would end up with is 8, and let's say I have 1 x and 4 y's. And in the bottom, all I have is a 3. Right, so if you want, you could write everything out, or you could do regular old canceling. 3 goes into 9 and 12. Okay, 7 goes into 14 twice. And so I see that there's my 8 in the numerator, and I'm going to have a 3 in the denominator. Now let's work with variables. I've got x cubed over x squared, so we're going to subtract exponents. That gives me an x in the numerator. And then I have a y times a y cubed, so you add exponents, that's going to be y to the fourth. So get the same answer. The main thing is to first multiply by the reciprocal. Okay, here's another one I want you to try. So put this on pause and multiply by the reciprocal, factor everything. After everything's factored, then see if anything cancels. Okay, so let's do it. Remember, we're going to factor each numerator and denominator after we multiply by the reciprocal. So first, I'm going to write 2x squared minus 3x minus 20 over 2x squared minus 7x minus 30 times the reciprocal. 4x squared plus 12x plus 9 over 2x squared minus 5x minus 12. Alright, so step 1, multiply by the reciprocal. I think I already had. There we go. Next step is to factor all of these. Now, these don't look too bad. Alright, no common factor in any of them. So let's see, this is going to be a 2x and an x. Now let's see, I've got to get factors of 20, See, it's going to be 5 and 4. It's going to be a minus and plus. That's what you should have gotten for that. This other one, this is a perfect square actually. 2x plus 3 and 2x plus 3. Let's see, I'm going to do this. This one looks easier over here. 2x and x. Let's see, factors of 12, 4 and 3. Be a minus, that'll be a plus. Alright, one more over here. Okay, so I need to get factors of 30, 3, 6, and 5. Let's see, it's going to be 5 and 6. So we're going to have minus. Okay. Alright, now's the fun part. After you go through all your factoring, which may have taken you 10, 15 minutes, who knows, on scratch paper, you go through and see what you can cancel. 2x plus 5 can cancel with that 2x plus 5. X minus 4 will go with that x minus 4. Let's see, 2x plus 3 with that 2x plus 3. And this 2x plus 3 and x minus 6 is all that's left. So our answer is 2x plus 3 over x minus 6. You know what simplifying, multiplying, and dividing rational expressions really does? It makes you practice your factoring and being very careful. Here's another one. Okay, this can be slightly tricky because I see that 2 minus x, but that's okay. That gives us an opportunity to practice with the negative signs. Okay, so step one, it's always the fraction after the division sign you change to multiply by the reciprocal. So we have x minus 3 over 2 minus x times the reciprocal, x squared plus 2x minus 8 over x squared plus 3x minus 18. Everything gets in parentheses, and now I do my factoring magic. Okay, so x minus 3, well, you can't do anything with that, so you still have x minus 3. How about x squared plus 2x minus 8? Well, it's got to be x and x, 4 and 2, plus and minus, there we go. Notice that I'm not showing you how to factor because I'm doing trial factors. This is something that you can have lots of scratch paper for and use a box method, use get one, you know, factor by grouping, however you want to do it. Right now on the bottom, I have a 2 minus x. I'm taking a look and I see that x minus 2. It's going to be able to cancel. So I'm going to write this as a negative 1 times x minus 2 instead of writing it as 2 minus x. That'll be easier when I cancel. And then x squared plus 3x minus 18. Let's see, that's an x and an x and a 6 and a 3 and a plus and a minus, and we've got it. Okay, so now's the fun part. Is there an x minus 3 I can cancel? Yes. Is there an x plus 4? No. Is there an x minus 2? Yes. There it is. Now, if I would have left that as 2 minus x, I could cancel, and then I'd write negative 1, because that's how it reduces, right? Now, when you just have a plain old negative 1 someplace, I usually write it out in front of the fraction bar. X plus 4 over x plus 6. You could leave it like that, or you could put a parentheses around it if you want. Or you could put a negative 1 in front of it. It's just the more standard way is just write the minus sign out in front. It looks a little bit neater. And there we go. So, those are lots of examples on dividing rational expressions. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.